In this video, we're going to talk about function transformations. So if we do certain operations and change the formula of the function a little bit, what happens to the graph? Does it shift up or down? Does it shift left or right? Does it stretch or shrink vertically or horizontally? What about reflections? Coming right up. Before we start, I want to point something out to you about functions. You notice that what we feed into the function f of x is x. X is called the independent variable. And x has another name. We also call x the argument of the function. The argument of the function f. And remember, it's very normal to say y is f of x. You're going to want to remember both of these things going forward. The first translation or transformation I want to talk to you about is the vertical shift of the function f of x. So if we add d to f of x, remember, this is outside the argument of the function. It's plus d or minus d. It impacts the y coordinate. So you want to think to yourself, this is going to impact the y coordinate only, and it's outside the argument of the function. Outside the argument of the function, in which case, if it's plus d, it moves the function up a distance of d. If it's minus d, it moves the function down a distance of d. Let's have a look. You can see in the GeoGebra worksheet that I've written for us here, so we can see this demonstration. Here's my function f, and you're not given a formula for it, so we have to think through what the translations mean. And if I move d, if I add d and I add 2, notice how it's moving this up, 2. So if I started here at the point 0, 0, and it goes up to the point 0, 2. It only impacts the y coordinate. Now, if I subtract 1, so let's go down here to negative 1. Notice, if I start here at the point 0, 0, it goes down to the point 0, negative 1. It only impacts the y coordinate. Now, for this part C, if I have the point 1, negative 1 on my original function, so my original point is negative 1, 1. I said that wrong. So here's my value on my original function. My original function is just x, y. That point is going to become, let me make my e a little better there. The point becomes, well, it's outside the argument of the function, so it does not change the x value at all. But it does y equals f of x. It adds 1 to the y value. So the point, negative 1, 1, that's going to become negative 1, 2. And let's look on the graph. We've talked about a vertical shift up or down, and now we're going to talk about a horizontal shift. So I want to point out to you the difference here. Notice here we have f of x minus c. We're talking about inside the argument of the function. Inside the argument impacts the x coordinate. So this is the x coordinate only. I'll just abbreviate coordinate. If we subtract, I sometimes call this opposite land. It's the opposite of what your brain wants. But the way to think about it is, what would I have to do to x minus c to get back to x? Well, I have to add c, so the graph is shifted horizontally to the right a distance of c. If I have f and in the argument x plus c, what would I have to do to x plus c to get it back to x? I'd have to subtract left, so the graph is shifted horizontally left a distance of c. Let's have a look. So in this example, for part A, I'm going to have a horizontal shift to the right by 2. So part A, horizontal, right, because I would have to take x minus 2 and add 2, so it goes to the right by 2. So the new point becomes x plus 2, and I'm not doing anything to the y coordinate, y. And in the second case, I'm going to have a horizontal shift. Now, what would I have to do to x plus 3 to get it back to x? It's going to be a horizontal shift to the left because it's, I'm going to have to say x minus 3, and the new point here would be x minus 3. I'm not making any changes to the y coordinate, y. Let's consider what happens when we put in x minus 2 into the argument of the function. So you notice what happens is this is shifting to the right, just as predicted, by 2 units. Next, we'll consider part B of the example, f input x plus 3, and we expect that to shift the graph negative 3 or 3 to the left, which it does. Now let's consider an example that combines the two. So when you have these combination examples, just think how you would do this in real life. You do x first and then y. So we have a horizontal shift because I'm considering inside the argument of the function first, and that's inside the argument only impacts the x coordinate. And that's a horizontal shift to the right by 1 because it's x minus 1, and I have to think, what do I do to x minus 1 to get it back to x? I add 1. Then I have a vertical or a shift either up or down. It's outside the argument of the function. It impacts the y coordinate. So it's plus 2, so it must be up 2. So if I have a point on the original function y equals f of x, and that point is the xy point, the new point becomes the point x plus 1. What do I have to do to get back to x? I have to add 1. And then outside the argument of the function, I just do what it says, y, f of x equals y, no matter what I feed into f of x, plus 2. Let's see what that looks like. Stay tuned for part 2, which is coming up next. I would like to invite you to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks very much for listening.